Has this ever happened to you? You go to put a filter on your camera lens, and golly gee dang, it won't heckin' fit.
Why won't this f***ing work?
You bought the wrong size, you dangus. Of course, we could just use step-up rings, but uh-oh, it got stuck to your lens. And that sucker's tighter than a pickle jar frozen in a block of ice.
Whatever will we do?
Let's try H and Y.
Why?
Why, you ask?
Well, H&Y's new Black Mist filter comes equipped with their patented technology, Revo Ring. And no, we're not talking about the newest Halo Ring. And now we'll pass it off to our spokesman who has a mustache against everyone else's better judgment, and he'll give you all the details. Thanks for tuning in.
What's one thing all of us stinky little camera folks love to talk about? That's right. Filters. Today, we're talking about a brand new filter set from our friends H&Y, the Revo Ring Black Mist. Black Mist is just a fancy schmancy term for diffusion, and diffusion is just a fancy term for it make highlight go bloom. So we're gonna start off with the H&Y Black Mist 8th Revo Ring. Wow, isn't that epic? See, I have this light back here so we can see the difference in the diffusion, so we'll show the first without the diffusion, and then now with the 1/8 on. Dude, this is insane. I'm really excited about this Revo Ring with Black Mist for a couple reasons. Number one, it finally solves my problem of always getting my regular diffusion filters and ND filters stuck to my lenses. It happens to me on a weekly basis, I kid you not. So here's how this bad boy works. You grab your Revo Ring, and there's a rugged ring on the outer part of the ring. You twist that, and it makes these little collapsible mounting points go inward, then you take your lens and literally just put the frickin' things inside the filter thread, let go, and it clasps the inside of the filter thread. So now this thing is holding my Sigma 50 to 100 and it's actually really stable. I don't wanna get too wild with it, but it's definitely sturdy, and all you do to take it off is you twist that same ring and then it comes out. So it's very simple, very fast, and it's pretty sick. No more getting my step-up rings and filters stuck to my lenses, thank God. So now let's move on to reason two why I'm super pumped about these filters, the diffusion. So the Revo Ring has been out for quite a while, but this new version comes with built-in Black Mist diffusion. And you can choose between three different strengths. You got your 1/8, 1/4, and then 1/2 if you really wanna get extra Philip bloominess. And you can choose between two different Revo Ring sizes. One is 42 to 62, and the other one is 67 to 82. And the 67 to 82 is perfect for me because most of my lenses have front filter threads of 72 to 82 millimeters. So this bigger size will fit all of my lenses. But there are also different bundle options that you can get magnetic VND and circular polarizers if you want all of your filtration to be a part of one simple system. It's up to you. And the magnetic front filter caps are pretty dang sweet. It's just really convenient. So I'm just glad. I'm happy that the days of step-up rings and sleepless nights over stuck filters are finally over. All right, we're gonna swap our 1/8 for the 1/4 now.
Whoop. Got it.
Yeah, we got a little bit extra bloominess now. It's looking pretty cool. We'll get to the 1/2 here in a second. Don't worry, folks. This all sounds great, right? Hassle-free filters that are still super affordable compared to the other competitors out there. Yeah, but how do they actually feel to use? Are they functional? Does the diffusion look nice? I was super impressed at how lightweight these babies are. When I first cracked them open, I was like, okay, this is pretty big compared to most other circular filters on the market, but they're nice and lightweight, but they still feel durable. This is like an aluminum or metal build quality, which is really nice, and the glass feels like glass, so that's great. But despite the larger size, they're super convenient to use, especially for my fast-paced workflow where I'm kind of running around with different cameras, a variety of different lenses, and I can just clamp these babies on and count on them. And I don't have to worry about like slowing down to be careful with my step-up rings and variable NDs. These things just work. And when it comes to the image, I actually really like how they look. I'm a big fan of diffusion filters that add that creamy bloom to the highlights, but don't take away that hearty helping of contrast from the image that I also love. Some other filters out there on the market add way too much bloom, or they take out way too much contrast, or maybe both. But these filters have a great bloom to contrast ratio. I think we gotta put the half on now. I just gotta show you guys. Here's the Mac Daddy, the one half. All right, see, we still got a decent amount of contrast. I'll leave the color grade the same so you can see an actual comparison, but we got this beautiful bloom in the back. Still not overwhelming the image though, which is really, really nice for me. So these filters are great in my opinion, but are they the right choice for you and your workflow? Well, ultimately, I can't speak for you, and if I could, you'd probably be mad at all the fart jokes I'd make you say. But what I can say is I think these filters can really fit a variety of different workflows. Keep in mind, I'm a YouTube boy. I'm running and gunning, getting test footage of a variety of different cameras and lenses, and I don't really want to be slowed down by the gear I have. So for me, these are going to be a really great addition to my kit because I can just plop them on and trust that they're going to work. I can also see these being a really good option for solo shooters or maybe people running smaller cinema or mirrorless camera rigs. The Revo Ring gives you kind of a similar look to using a small matte box on the front of your camera. So it looks professional and a little bit bigger, beefier, but it also gives you some of the same function of a matte box. And some people might even find it more appealing to use something like the Revo Ring over a matte box due to the magnetic nature of being able to snap on the VND or the circular polarizer without having to slide in those big glass elements on a matte box. I don't know, it's ultimately up to you and your workflow, but in my opinion, these could work for a variety of different people.
So you finally wised up and got the Revo Ring Black Mist, huh? What a smart young man who has a mustache for some reason. Try Revo Ring today using our affiliate link in the description. Side effects may include getting hired to film a Chris Nolan movie because your footage is so damn cinematic. Soft baby palms because you're not using them to pry off step-up rings. Hazy vision, being better than your coworkers. An increase in wealth due to not having to buy a million other filters. And finally, true happiness in this short little thing we call life.
HNY does not approve any of the previous statements. All opinions are my own and we appreciate them for sending us the filters. Check out the HNY Revo Ring Black Mist filters in the affiliate link in the description. And thank you for shopping at Kinoteca. Subscribe to join the camera camp, and we'll see you very soon. Thanks for watching.
With quality.